Hi, this is Kurt with Traverse Tool Company. Today we're going to talk about the three most common collets. Let's start off with the R8 collet. Chances are pretty good. If you have a milling machine, you have R8 collets that go with it. Thing about these is they have a notch in them that goes up into the spindle and catches on a little pin to keep it from turning when you tighten it up with the drawbar that goes down into the screw. But each one has a certain size on it, and that's the only size that it's going to be able to hold. So its versatility isn't really huge, but as long as you have standard size end mills or shanks, these things are going to be great. If you need more versatility than an R8 collet can provide for you, an ER collet might be the solution. Unlike an R8 collet, an ER holds a variety of sizes, or actually a range of sizes, so even if you have a metric tool, you'd still be able to fit it in a standard ER collet. So if you want to use ER collets in your milling machine, I have here an ER 40 collet. Here's an ER 40 chuck. Notice this has an R8 shank on it, so I can put it in my R8 spindle in the milling machine. And all you do is you put the short end in the nut, screw that on, put your end mill or drill bit, whatever's going in there, get your spanner wrench and tighten up on that nut, and it's clamped really securely. The shanks, by the way, are available in a variety of different style shanks. So this is the R8. As I said, it's available in straight shanks, Cat 40, Cat 30, other different shanks for different types of machines. So far we've been talking about tool holding collets. What I mean by that is they hold a cutting tool, whether it's an end mill, a drill bit, maybe a drill chuck shank, something like that. Now we're going to switch gears a little bit and talk about a work holding collet. These are 5C collets, and to show you what I mean by work holding, I have a workpiece here that goes right into the collet. They have a big hole in the back so that the workpiece can go all the way through. Since the 5C collets are for holding workpiece materials, there's a lot of variety of ways you can use them. So we have collets that'll hold a square workpiece, another one that'll hold a hex-shaped workpiece. We even have an expandable collet that you can customize by turning the outside diameter and it opens up onto a workpiece. We have emergency collets where you can bore out the inside to a custom shape that you might have. And we have step collets where you machine your own step in it to hold the workpiece that you have to hold in there. And these are available in different sizes. These are three different type of fixtures that a 5C collet can go into. Let's start with this one. So you put the collet in this end. Obviously tighten it in there, put your workpiece in, then you can either clamp this in a vise, fasten it down to the T-slots in the table, you can even turn it up to make it vertical, and you can machine the workpiece that's in this collet. This lever on the side, once you have the collet tight in there, you just use this lever that's on the side to tighten it and loosen it, so it's pretty fast to get each workpiece in and out of there. Next we have this spin fixture. Again, you put your collet inside here and tighten it in, put your workpiece in there obviously, and then you can spin it in either a surface grinder or a milling machine, however you want to use it. If you were curious about why I had trouble getting that in there, on the 5C collet as well as the R8 collet, it has that little slot that has to line up with a pin. So you kind of have to feel around for it until it goes in. And finally, we have the square and the hex-shaped fixture blocks. What those are for is to put the collet into. Then you can either use the nut that comes along with it and put a spanner wrench to tighten the collet onto the workpiece. Then you can put that in a vise, machine one side, flip it over, machine another side, and you can actually machine the round part into a square. If you don't want to use the nut, you can use the cam lock, and just by, oops, it wasn't tight quite. There we go. Just by pulling back, got it. So just by pulling back on that, it holds the workpiece. Now you can see I had a little bit of trouble with this. I personally don't like this. I prefer the nut way more than these, even though it releases it quickly. But I'd rather take the time and use the nut on it because it's so much more secure. Then if you need to machine something that's hex-shaped, obviously would use the hex shape, and or you can machine just three sides, however you want to use that. Here's a question for you. Would a video on any of these fixtures, or maybe the expanding collet, the step collet, or the emergency collet, be helpful to you? If you'd like to see more about those, comment below, notify us, contact us somehow, and we'll get another video out there for you.